بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. My dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Alert news. Emergency. Quick reminder, my brothers and my sisters. This beautiful guest, which been with us over 20 days, 20 nights, honorable guest, coming from the Kareem, from the Arhamur Rahimin, is getting ready to depart. He's taking with him the names which are written among those people who are free from the hellfire. He's taking with him the Qiyam and the Siyam for those people which Allah Azza wa Jalla accepted from them. My brothers and my sisters, are you one of them? I'm one of them. Who knows except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the door is still there. The chance is still there. The Prophet says in hadith, Man sama Ramadan, whoever fasts Ramadan, imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddam min dhanb. With iman and with a hope, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept it, Allah will forgive his sins. Who knows, our fasting was 100%. How many backbiting we went through? How many slandering we went through? How many seen haram or listen to haram we went through? Then the Prophet gave us another hope. He said, Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddam min dhanb. Whoever stand up in Ramadan in a prayer with iman wa ihtisab, and is hoping from Allah, he's striving so Allah can accept it from him, Allah forgive his sins. Who is that person from us who can say, every prayer I was with khushu, with humble, I was tadabbur, I was pondering the words of Allah, I was worshipping Allah just like I see him. So the last chance, my brothers and sisters, is this 10th night. The Prophet says, Man qama laylatul qadri imanan wa ihtisaba ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. If somebody stand up in laylatul qadr with iman and striving and have the hope that Allah, beg Allah to accept from him, Allah will forgive his sins. My brother, laylatul qadr could be tonight. Nobody knows the Laylatul Qadr except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We started the Ramadan and we couldn't see the moon. The night which you think is odd night could be different night. The night which you think is not the odd night could be the odd night. Those people who looking to worship Allah Azza wa Jal temporary, only in the night what he think later to la yuwaffaq. If you're looking just to get only the night what he think could be later to Qadr, Allah will not give it to him. Ya no laysa imanan wa ihtisab. He just try to do as much and less work he can do. My brother, Laylatul Qadr, Allah says, Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. Subhanallah. Did you ever stop in this eye and think? Laylatul Qadr khayrun, not equal, way more than 1,000 months. We know that. Let's say 1,000 months equals 1,000 months. which is 84 years of worship, day and night, no sleep, no food, no water. One night, how many hours, my brother? I want you to think. One night, I'm talking to every person who listened to me. One night, how many hours? 10 hours? If you count it from 8 to 5, 6 o'clock, 10 hours. One night. Subhanallah. If the you boss at work telling you and me, if you work 1 hour extra from your regular hours, I will pay you the salary of 2 months. You will reject? I will reject. 1 hour, 60 minutes. You will get the ratib, the salary of 2 months. You will do. You will thank him to the maximum. So he did this goodness and this favor to you. Imagine if he tells you, if you work 5 hours extra, I will give you the salary of 1 year. No matter how many plans you have, no matter where you're supposed to go after you work, none of that matters. You will do these 5 hours. Why? The reward is 1 year of salary. My brother, imagine. Imagine Kareem, Arhamur Rahimin, Al-Aziz, he's telling you, 1 hour, you know how much is the equal? Equals 8 years of worship, 1 hour, 10 hours a night, 1 hour, if that night is Laylatul Qadr, equals 8 years of worship, day and night. No sleep, no food, no work. This is if is equal to 1,000 nights, but it's not equal. It's khair, way more. When Allah say way more, that means that thing is huge. Because he left it, that reward, as a surprise. If I tell you, brother, you do this job, I give you $100. And you tell somebody, if you do this for me, I have a special gift for you. You know that not gift will not be something $100 or $10, because it's coming from somebody who is Kareem. So you are guests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these nights. Don't you want your name to be written among the people who are free? So what we should do in these nights, my brothers, and what is the best reward? The best deeds you can do, and you are in a house of the Akramul Akramin. You are guest of Rabbul Alameen. The best thing we can do, my dear brothers and sisters, is to apply this beautiful ayah which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Zumar.
أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا.
Allah is talking about those people. The people who left their beds, left his desires when the people are asleep. He moved from his bed. He left his family. And he stood up in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla. He's praying or nasu, niyam. He chose Allah over his desires. He wants his name to be free, to be written from the people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala free them from the hellfire. You know what that means? Which means there is no adab in the qabr. Which means there is no punishment in mahshar. No punishment in sirat. No punishment in yawm al-qiyamah. You are free from the hellfire forever. La ilaha illallah. The price is huge.
أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا.
قَانِتٌ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا. In prostration.
أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا وَقَائِمًا.
سُجُود. قِيَام. What for? Why is doing this? يحذر الآخرة. He's worried about the آخرة. He saw Allah, they will come a day I have to stay. I have to stand there 50,000 years. The sun will be 1 mile over my head. Nobody will care about me. Oh Allah, that I'm looking for those days, for that time, to you choose me and put me under the shade. تحت ظلك يوم لا ظل إلا ظلك. In that day where there is no other shade except the shade which is from the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, I'm looking for those days. Do you call me أين الصائمون? And I'm one of them. أين المتقون? And I'm one of them. أين القائمون? I'm one of them. أين الصادقون? I'm one of them. ويحذر الآخرة ويرجو رحمة ربه. He has a fear, but also he has a hope. He's looking for the rahmah of Allah. ويرجو رحمة ربه. He's looking for the rahmah, which every one of us is looking for. That is the key to enter in Jannah, my brothers and sisters. يعلموا, the Prophet says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يعلموا أنه لا يدخل أحد منكم الجنة بعملي. None of you will enter in Jannah with his deeds. قالوا يا رسول الله ولا أنت. Neither you praying to قيام, in قيام حتى تتفطر قدماه, until his legs were swollen. Aisha said, Ya Rasulallah, why are you doing this? Why are you in this pain? You're struggling so much in worship, and Allah has forgiven to you any sin in future and before. You are free. But he knew who Allah is. قَالَ يَا عَائِشَ أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Therefore I deserve to worship Allah more. How can I thank Him? Do He choose me to be forgiven? Subhanallah. So يرجو رحمة ربي. He's wishing for that rahmat, because the Prophet says, neither me will enter in Jannah with my deeds. إلا أن يتغمدنا الله برحمته. Except if Allah Azza wa Jal put His mercy, shower His mercy upon us. That's what we wish. We read Quran, we wish in the rahmah. وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. When we give salam in the prayer, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. When somebody sneezes, we say alhamdulillah, we say يَرْحَمُكَ اللَّهُ. When somebody died, we say rahimahullah, because that is the key to enter in Jannah. And then in Jannah, Allah will put you in the level based on your deeds. We urge rahmat Allah. He asking Allah for this rahmat. Then Allah continue the ayah and He says, قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Want to know who are the people who have knowledge? Allah says, Ask ya Muhammad, you want to know who are really the people who know who Allah is? Those people which we just mentioned before. Those people who stand up in prayer. أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ أَنَّاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا وَقَائِمًا وَيَحْذَرُ الْآخِرَةِ وَيَرْجُ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّهِ. قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Those people who know Allah Azza wa Jal, not those who have a shahada, PhD, none of that matters, nor those who stand in a prayer when the people are asleep. إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. This is reminders for the people who have a who have an intellect, ulul albab, my brothers and my sisters, Laylatul Qadr, could be tonight, could be tomorrow, could be after 10 days. 10 days, you can free yourself from the hellfire. 10 days you can be from the people who will never be touched by the hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those people, my brothers and sisters. هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.